ಮಾಡಿರೋದು. ಬ್ರದರ್ ಲಬೀನ್ ಶಾಫಿ, ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ SIO ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ರೆಕ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಜನಾಬ್ ಹಾಮಿದ್ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಖಾನ್ ಸಹ, ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಜಮಾತ್ ಇಸ್ಲಾಮಿ ಹಿಂದ್ ತೆಲಂಗಾಣ, ಬ್ರದರ್ ಸೈಯದ್ ಅಹಮದ್ ಮುಜಕ್ಕಿರ್, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ CERT, ಕನ್ವೀನರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಕೊಲೋಕ್ಯಂ ಬ್ರದರ್ ಹಿಶಾಮುಲ್ ವಹಾಬ್, ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಪೇಪರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ 2 ಡೇಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಕೊಲೋಕ್ಯಂ, ಅಸ್ಸಲಾಮು ಅಲೈಕುಮ್ ವರಹಮತುಲ್ಲಾಹಿ ವಬರಕಾತು. ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಎಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ 2 ಡೇಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಶಾಪ್, in this valedictory session, Syed Ayub Ali Sahab, a professor, a retired professor from Kakatiya University, is also supposed to join this valedictory session. Because of sudden health issues, he did attend, came to this program, and he requested for the prayers. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah give him good health. Ameen. Dear brothers, as we are discussing on different histories of South India, the 7 states, the Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra, Goa, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, we have discussed various things and hope you people have got new ideas and new dimensions how the history has been distorted. As we all know, India is a home of 200 million Muslims, and we are the second largest Muslim populated country in India after Indonesia. When we are highly populated here in India, even though we are 14 to 15% according to statistical data, but the huge population and their history has a lot of contributions in India, and we have discussed various aspects since yesterday. But nowadays, if you are looking from, if you see the past 10 years of India, all the hate crimes which has been occurred in India in last 10 years, among the all hate crimes, the 60% victims are Muslims. And if you see the data of just 5 years, the 90% victims of all the hate crimes are Muslims. Similarly, the Mughal history, which has a rich content and they have a lot of contribution for developing this nation, then we regularly used to have a discussion on media platforms and social media in different ways. The actual history of Mughal, which was there in various textbooks of state syllabus, previously Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh has removed the Mughal chapter from the history of state textbooks. Following them, the Maharashtra recently, they do have removed the Mughal history from the textbooks. Those who have made the country, those who have formed the country, those who have made the country to the next level, they have removed their history. And you know, the many places are being changed with the old names. The history is also being distorted in new way. If you have observed in your cities, in your places, that every main road has been given with a new name, and we people never observe such things. Slowly and steadily they are changing the even the names of every street, and we feel that by looking the big boards in our areas, we feel there is a lot of development, but they are trying to, not trying to, but they are completely changing the names, and they are changing the history, which the rich history which the Muslims have given to this India. And if you see the latest issues which we are discussing every now and then, the Assam NRC, it has its own history. After the accord, after the division, after the partition of East and West Bengal, the issue has been happened, and now more than 19 lakh people are stateless. When British was there in the area of Northeast, they invited the Muslims from East India, now Bangladesh. Sorry, East Bengal, now it is called as Bangladesh. They invited Muslims for farming. They invited Muslims to cultivate the vegetables, because at that time there were no people who can do the farming exactly. And they invited some people from Bihar, they invited some people from West Bengal for the other works. So after these so many years, now they are not ready to accept those Muslims as the citizens of India. 2 to 3 generations have been passed, yet the people, the government and the system authorities are not accepting them as citizens of India. And the rest of the issue, you know in better way. Similarly, if you see the every state, as we are saying about the Assam, and every state of India has some problems. If you see the state of Uttar Pradesh, more than 1100 fake encounters. It's the biggest issue in Uttar Pradesh, and most of the victims are again Muslims. Similarly, if you see the state of Haryana, Rajasthan, there every now and then the lynchings happens, and the victims are mostly either Dalits or Muslims, or marginalized communities. If you see the state of Jharkhand, there the issue of minings, which is a political biggest issue, and it is creating the environmental disturbances there. And if you see the state of Maharashtra, there is the biggest issue of farmers. Farmers issue is we are seeing in entire India, but focusing the Maharashtra, it is largest compared to other states. So these issues, when we are discussing about these issues, it does not mean that we are feeling something wrong, or we are in a situation, or we are in a position that we cannot do anything. But as a citizen of India, as we are a citizens of India, and especially we the people, especially Muslims, the Ummah of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we have a responsibility to contribute to the society, to reconstruct the society, and to develop the nation in a better way. These challenges, these issues are the opportunities which we can take and move ahead to construct the better society. In this such a situation, in this political scenario, the responsibility on we students increases a lot. We are those people who are going to narrate the future politics, inshallah. And the history what we discussed here, it is not for the closed room, it is not for the to make any document and to keep in the libraries, but it is to make the narratives, it is made to make the people to learn. As yesterday was also, we were the people have said here regarding the history summit series we have conducted previously. SIO started this series in 2018 with the All India History Summit. Now we are doing South India History Colloquium, then North India, then Northeast India. It may happen in future, inshallah, every state may conduct this type of histories. And not only every state, if we move ahead, every area has its own importance in Indian history. If you see, especially the Deccan, the Hyderabad Deccan, how this has been divided when the reorganization bill has been happened. The Hyderabad has divided into 3 states. Now if you see the Telangana state, the part of Telangana, north part of Karnataka, and south part of Maharashtra. These 3 special regions, one state has been divided into 3, and they have connected to other states. This is just not the division of state or geographical division. What we feel is, this is the actual division of Muslims. If the Hyderabad state was now as previous, then it would be the, like Punjab, we see the majority is Punjabis. Similarly, we used to see the Hyderabad Deccan with the majority of Muslims, but they have divided for the political reasons. And now we are in no position to have a space in the political sphere. When we learn the history, when we know about the history, there is a lot of contribution of Indian Muslims here to develop both in political, economical, social, and in every aspect, especially in education, health sector also. And it's our responsibility to continue the legacy of our contributors so that we can develop the India in a more better position. As we are looking now, the GDP is less than 5. Inshallah, the day will come again if we plan and if we try to contribute and if we have a commitment to contribute to the nation, we can again go to the golden history. When the Mughal was here, we have the exact content that the economy here was the highest in the entire world. So we can easily make this country a better nation, a peaceful nation, by knowing the actual histories and making the future narratives. I take this opportunity in front of you with a hope that you people, from leaving this workshop, you will contribute to the society, you will try to make the big narratives, and instead of, as the hate is being promoted in the society, and oppositely, we have to promote the peace in the societies so that we can make the better India and the better future of India and Indian citizens. Thank you for this opportunity. Jazakallah khair. Wa akhiru da'wana. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.